everyone, I'm Nishu and I'm going to start a new chapter from Unit 2, that is your Principles of Mendelian Inheritance. Children, till yet we have finished the Unit 1, Reproduction, where we have completed 4 chapters related to reproduction. And we came to know that how your asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction takes place. How a new young one, new progeny, comes to the world either following the asexual mode of reproduction or the sexual reproduction mode. Now children, in this chapter, the important thing that we are going to study is that how the character is being transferred from the parent to the next generation. In the first unit, we have studied that how a new generation comes to the world. And here in this unit, we are going to cover that how the characters are being transferred from the parent generation to the next generation, coming generation. So children, starting with the chapter, let us first again know that what are the topics that we are going to cover in the chapter. That is your Principles of Mendelian Inheritance, which is your chapter number 5 according to your NCERT book. Now children, let us see the topics to be covered. Now children, the first topic which we need to cover is your introduction. Introduction is a basic thing which we need to cover for everything, for every topic. Then the second topic is your Mendel's Law of Inheritance. The third is inheritance of one gene. Then inheritance of two genes. Then your sex determination, then your mutation, and then is your genetic disorder. Children, these are the topics which we are going to cover in this chapter, Principles of Mendelian Inheritance. Now children, the name of the chapter is Principles of Mendelian Inheritance. What do you mean by principles? Here, the term principles mean rules, different type of rules which are made to study of what? Of Mendelian inheritance. Mendelian is your Mendel. He was a scientist in the study of genetics. So Mendelian and inheritance. Inheritance means all those characters which are transferred from one generation to the next generation. So here in this chapter we are going to study that what are the rules which was framed by Mendel in your inheritance, in the transfer of the characters from one generation to another. Now children, these are the topics which we are going to cover. Now suppose children, if I get a different type of questions to you all. Now, have you ever thought that why and how human beings produce their own types? Now, how plants produce their own similar types? How animals like cat, dogs, elephant produce their own progeny? Progeny means their next generations, their next offsprings which are coming to the next one. So how they look same to each other? How they are similar to each other? Have you thought of all these things? How the human beings, next generation, their young babies are having the same characters of their parent? Have you ever thought? Now children, in this chapter, we are going to get answer to those questions only. That how all these similar characters, how these your same characteristic features are being transferred from the parent generation to the next generation. Now, through these topics, through these principles, through these laws, we are going to develop that understanding that how your new generations are getting the characters from the parent into them. How these characters are being transferred from the one generation to next generation. And we are going to develop an understanding of these rules through the study of genetics. So children, in this chapter now, we should start that what is genetics. With that we are going to study. So firstly children, before starting the chapter, I would like to discuss little bit discoveries related to the topics. Now genetics is a vast field and vast till dated your new researches are going on, and many persons are involved in this field. But the persons whom I am going to discuss now are most important, who are related to the topics, your principles of Mendelian inheritance. So children, let me first discuss about the persons who are involved in the field of principles of Mendelian inheritance and variations. So now let us children move ahead to know the important persons who have given their contribution to the field of genetics. So children, let us start. Now the first name you can see is your W. Bateson. W. Bateson was the person who has coined the term genetics. The word genetics has been given by W. Bateson. All their works we will be discussing later in the further parts of the chapter, but this section is made only to know that who are the persons who are involved in the studies of genetics related to principles of Mendelian inheritance and variations. So children, the first name which I am telling you is your W. Bateson, and this person was related to the coining of the term genetics. Now children, if I go to the second name, Gregor Johann Mendel. This is a name of a scientist whose name is very familiar to you all, and this person was responsible here, and he was known as father of genetics. G.J. Mendel, Gregor Johann Mendel, is known as father of genetics. Children, now again coming back to the same name, W. Bateson, he is known as father of modern genetics. Today, whatever modern genetics is in front of us, that modernity to the genetic subject, the tools and alls were given by W. Bateson, and hence he is known as father of modern genetics. Now children, T.H. Morgan, another name, is one of the most important name in the study of genetics, in the field of study of genetics. Children, linkage, recombination and various new experiments, new terms have been proved by him, and he was also known as father of experimental genetics. So children, W. Bateson coined the term genetics. John Gregor Mendel, G.J. Mendel, he is known as father of genetics. W. Bateson is known as father of modern genetics, and T.H. Morgan is known as father of experimental genetics. Now children, moving to the another name, that is your A. Gerard. Now A. Gerard is also known as father of human genetics and biochemical. Human genetics related to human DNA, chromosomes, all those things were expressed by your A. Gerard. And children, he was the first person to discover the human metabolic genetic disorder, and this human metabolic disorder was named as alkaptonuria. Now children, by the name alkaptonuria, you can see here urea word is coming. So something is related to urine. So this human metabolic genetic disorder was related to urine, and this disease is only called as your black urine disease. So children, A. Gerard is responsible for the discovery of alkaptonuria, and he was called as father of human genetics and biochemistry. Now children, next name again, you can see here, W. Bateson. He is very important person related to genetics. He coined the term allele. Now children, what is allele? In the further chapter, we will be knowing that what is allele. So W. Bateson coined the term allele. Now again children, W. Bateson coined the term heterozygous and homozygous. Children, these are the terminologies which we will be discussing just a few minutes later after this. That what is allele, what is homozygous, what is heterozygous. These are the few terminologies, which terms which we will be discussing. So W. Bateson gave the term for your homozygous and heterozygous. Now children, Gregor Johann Mendel, G.J. Mendel, he coined the term factor. Now what is factor? We will be again knowing it, that what is factor. Then Wilhelm Johansson, he gave the term gene in 1909. Now children, these were the persons who are related to the study of genetics, who are related to give the principles for the Mendelian inheritance and variations. Now children, after knowing all these persons, we will be discussing few important terms of the topic. Now children, knowing these terms in the beginning is very necessary to get the exact meaning, to get the complete understanding of the chapter in the beginning only. If we are knowing the meaning of these terms in the beginning, the later part of the chapter will become very easy for us. So children, in the beginning only, I'll be discussing few of the terminologies, and then completing that, I will be moving to the chapter. Hope children, you have understood, and you will be learning the names of these researchers, of these scientists, which will make the study of genetics very easy for you. It will help in developing the understanding of genetics among you. Thank you.